The trend to learn new elements at a higher and higher level of difficulty and complexity continued in the 1980s, contrary to the determination of European coaches who feared risking their athletes to injury. Also, there was an increasing trend towards lightness and smallness. As gymnasts grew younger and younger, grace disappeared from artistic gymnastics to be replaced by acrobatics. The movements were too difficult for older gymnasts who were too old to recover from injury. The days of the adult female gymnasts of the 1960s, such as Latynaya, at 31 years old as a Soviet leader, were gone to be replaced by young teenage girls. At the end of the 1980s, a new breed of power gymnasts had taken the scene, such as Mary Lou Retton, the first Olympic gold all-around for Americans. Even with the emergence of power in women's artistic gymnastics, not all events lost artistry and grace. Those strength moves and complex combinations increased on the balance beam. It did not lose its artistry. Also, the widening of the uneven bars permitted artistry by allowing swinging giants without a pike and more fluid routines. Moreover, the least graceful apparatus, the vault, increased its artistry with the development of the Yurchenko, a round-off backhand spring vault. As third-wave feminism rolled onto the scene in the early 1990s, the 1996 Atlanta Olympics was dubbed the Year of the Woman. Unlike any other Olympics that preceded, the focus on female athletes was part of a much larger national focus on women in sports. Due to the reason that the 90s marked the first generation of women who benefited from the implementation of Title IX of the Education Act of 1972.
Ooh, then bring it on! Oh, unless of course you're afraid you might lose to a bunch of girls.
Though the Magnificent Seven won the first team gold in American women's gymnastic Olympic history, the spotlight was not on them but rather Carrie Strug, due to heroics on the last rotation. After sure thing Dominique Marciano fell on her two vaults, Carrie Strug was the team's last hope against the Russians. At this time, few spectators were aware of the constant pain and injury gymnasts worked through, thus allotting the apologetic label given in the 60s. Carrie Strug, however, publicly demonstrated the mental toughness of female gymnasts when she completed her second vault with two torn ligaments. Since the Atlanta Games, artistic gymnastics has been running away from grace and elegance due to the removal of the compulsories and the perfect 10. Compulsories are basically a chase for perfection. Each gymnast on every team must perform the same routine, and the acrobatic elements are usually at a low level to place an emphasis on technique rather than power and strength. Thus, with only the optionals left in competition, gymnastics focuses on innovation and difficulty. In addition, the new code of points used in the 2008 Olympics moved away from the perfect 10 to an open-ended point system, which also focuses on difficulty to rack up points.
Our art is power.
Though Russia and Romania dominate the sport at the international level due to their grace, the American team is steadily becoming a top contender in women's artistic gymnastics. The U.S.'s preference for power can be seen in the Olympic trials where powerhouse Shawn Johnson was placed over the balletic Nastia Lukin. However, it appears that the international scene still prefers grace, as Nastia earned gold in the Beijing Olympic all-around. As women increase the difficulty of their skills, they are rapidly approaching the difficulty level of men's artistic gymnastics.
Because I'm a woman. What do you think, I cannot work that hard? You know, I think we are better than guys.